Boys VW Fastback is undergoing its own transformation. At the body shop, the car is ready for its new colour. And having been cut down to size, Drew's bespoke bumper has been fully re-chromed. But Drew's not finished yet. He's ordered a reproduction set of Sprint Star alloy wheels for the car and has a special plan for the tyres.
So we are off to Stafford. We're off to meet a guy called Ant, and I've got the new wheels and tyres for the Fastback. And he's going to put a red wall on them for me. So a little thin red band is what I'm after for them.
For almost a decade, Ant Edensor, aka Mr. Whitewall, has been helping car fanatics custom paint the sidewalls of their tyres.
I am the only person in the UK that does this. So I get customers travelling the length and the breadth of the country. I can do many different stripes, so we could start off with quite a thin stripe, ranging up to like the old American 50s style stripes, so 3-inch stripes plus. The wheel's your oyster.
This is what I'm after.
Okay.
That red band there, it's about the right width, that, about 1/4 inch.
Okay.
And then, see this, can we do it around here somewhere?
Yeah, that's a perfect place for it.
Just there?
Yeah.
A lot of the slightly Americanized hot rods from the late 60s into the 70s, you know, those massive big chargers and that sort of thing, would have these red band tires on them. And they just look really attractive. They just look good.
The striping will cost around £150. And the first stage for Ant is to create a smooth channel for the new paint. Using a specially adapted buffing wheel, he can skim off the raised lettering on the sidewall without affecting the structural integrity of the tyre.
Wow. Just cut straight through it.
Yep.
Beautiful.
To paint on the red stripe, Ant has an applicator tool designed specifically for the job.
Oh, it's like a little, just a little roller?
Yeah, yeah.
And so what you squish through and it comes through
it's
from a pinhole in there and then onto the roller?
That's it, exactly.
Do you do this by hand or is now this is on a mount?
No, no, it's all hand done.
OK, over to
it's
you.
All hand done. So the thinner the stripe, the steadier the hand you need.
That looks good already.
That's just the first coat, but it's just a case of layering it up now until you get the full solid colour. Is that the sort of look you're after?
Mate, perfect. Exactly what I was after.
It is just a little bit of jewellery. It's all this is. It's a tiny detail, makes a massive difference. Oh, yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's perfect. I love that the classic car community has people like Ant in it, just tiny niche businesses that are doing really good work for not a lot of money. Right, three more. I'll go and get another one.
OK.
At the workshop, the VW is back from the paint shop, and the team are working flat out to deliver Drew's unique vision.
The VW Fastback is really starting to come together. It's looking awesome. The paintwork is done, and Drew's bumper has gone on.
48 hours later, the car's complete.
I'm extremely excited today. We're off to see the Fastback, and as you know, the bumper's a bit of a punt, really, isn't it? So we'll see whether or not I'm wrong.
Paul's arranged to take the VW to a very special event and has asked Drew to meet him en route.
Right. Come on, Cowland, want to see this car?
How good does that look?
That looks fantastic. Right, let's have a look at the bumper.
The bumper.
Wow. I think that works. It just works. Your thoughts, Mr. Cowland?
Do you know what? Oh, it's horrible to say these words. It's painful to get them out.
Go on, you can do it.
I really like it.
Sorry, what was that?
Anyway, let's move on.
No, sorry, the wind caught your voice.
Good.
There. What was that?
I really quite like it.
You like it?
Mm.
Excellent. Paul gave me a load of grief about the bumper. A phone call saying, mate, this is a waste of money, da-da-da-da-da. But you know what? I'm happy now I've seen it. You know, because it was the overall view I had for the car, it's exactly what I wanted. It's better than I imagined.
Now wait till you see inside.
Oof!
Look at this.
Oh, mate, that's nice. Oh, you've done the dash as
yeah,
well.
Dash has been repaired.
Get in! What a nice motor.
Everything we've done, the paint, the wheels, the tyres, including the world's most expensive bumper, car now owes you £9,500.
I think that's a steal.
I think it's pretty decent, because I think yeah. That's an easy 10,995. Maybe a little bit more?
Mm. I think so.
With Drew happy, it's time to hit the road.
This is a nice car. This is a really nice car. It's absolutely lovely. This is the thing with Type 3s. They drive so well.
They do, that gear change is
like... You know, it's just, it's in the day, this must have felt so modern. It's quiet, comfortable. I feel like I could drive it anywhere, really.
There's a group of Type 3 owners having a bit of a meet today.
Yeah.
And I thought we could show them, get the vibe for the car, and maybe, you never know, find it a new home.
You never know, that is the way to sell it. Don't mention the bumper to them. I want to see if they notice it.
The boys have come to Shelsley Walsh in Worcestershire.
Hello.
Where a group of die-hard Type 3 fanatics are showing off their cars.
I've never seen this many Type 3s in one place.
No. Yeah, it's pretty rare, isn't it?
Oh, look at that. Wow. Wow. That's a belter. It's a
weapon,
isn't
it?
That's lovely, isn't it?
Love that.
I love the roof colours, don't you?
Yeah. Yeah. You know what I'd do with it?
Go on.
Sunroof.
You would as well.
But soon, it's Drew and Paul's car that's hogging the limelight.
Colour's spot on as well.
You like
lovely,
it?
Lovely colour in it, and it really suits the car, I think.
There you go.
Don't make his head any bigger.
Honestly.
What have we done to the front end? Subtle modification to the bumper.
Oh, there you go. Well, he's fine here.
I'm a winner.
What, do I win the car?
No. No. Yes.
Looks a lot better.
I couldn't be more pleased with what the lads were saying about the car. They were all saying, I like the colour. I like what you've done with the front bumper.
I don't mind eating humble pie. It's a pie I've had to eat many times.
This car has come from myself and Paul's passion for VWs of all types.
10995, someone could take it away today.
VW seen as a community. It will get round quickly, but this car is out there for sale, and it's a really nice one, and it's different. And I reckon one of these lads will put it out there, jungle drums, and it'll get sold.
And sure enough, just a couple of weeks later, there's been a development.
Good news, we've had a VW nut call up and buy our Volkswagen Fastback. Best of all, they've paid £10,750, which gives us round about £1,200 profit. I'd like to spend a bit more, but you know what? Car's gone to a good home. That's a decent sale, isn't it?